All right, what's going on, you guys? Nick here with Nick Strength and Power. We've got a couple interesting stories to talk about today, so let's get straight into it here. Let's start off the video with some Europa Spain stories, particularly Regan Grimes, who is preparing for the Europa Spain one day out. So tomorrow, Sunday, October 11th, is the pro portion of this Europa competition. So tomorrow is the pro portion. Today is like the NPC stuff. So if you guys are looking for the live stream, you're probably going to want to be watching tomorrow. So Regan Grimes preparing for the Spain Pro. Now you guys know that Rami is not in this lineup, so they don't have to worry about him anymore. Regan is looking pretty good. He's posted a lot of back shots. This is a back training video that you're watching right now. He looks like he's in pretty good shape here. This lineup is a tough one. We're going to get to that in a minute, but it's kind of hard to predict who's going to win here. I think Regan's got a lot better shot at the top three here now that Rami is not in it. It's hard to make a prediction on who's going to win. Like I said, all these guys are kind of on an even playing field. They've all got very different physiques, but also they're kind of in the same caliber category. And it's really going to come down to conditioning, I think, is where this show is going to be, because all these guys, you know, Regan, Rafael, Milan, Lucas Osadil, these guys have very different structures, very different shapes. And I think conditioning is going to be the main thing that it comes down to at this show that really settles the difference between these guys. But Regan is looking good. He also posted this abs and thigh shot. He looks like he's in pretty good shape there. I'd like to see him a little bit drier, but again, he's still got one day to dry out. A back double bicep shot. He looks pretty good there. All the back shots that I've seen of Regan look really good. His hamstrings are in. His back is in. He's got a lot of good detail in his back right now. Again, I would like to see him a little bit drier, but we're going to see what he looks like tomorrow. Now, what do I mean when I'm talking about dry? Let's look at Milan Sadic, another guy in this lineup. He just posted a posing video, and he looks extraordinarily dry. He's in really good shape. He's really conditioned, and he looks dry as a bone. And this, I think this video we're watching right now was a day ago, so this was 2 days out. And this is the conditioning we want to see on this Spain Pro stage. He's in really great shape. And if you look at this picture here, this most muscular picture of Milan, you can really see what I'm talking about. Look at the separation in his legs. Look at the separation in his shoulders, the striations in his shoulders, how dry he looks in these pictures. That's what we want to see from these guys in the Spain lineup. So don't be surprised if you see Milan in this top three. Again, look at that separation in his legs. I mean, it's gnarly, the shape that he's in. And then, of course, you've got James Hollingshead, another guy that in the pictures and in the updates that you've seen on Instagram, James looks insane. And I was talking to someone about this yesterday. And here's the thing. When you've got a guy, a white guy, and I mean that because it's the way that the light reacts to the color of the physique. When you've got a guy like James that's kind of a real pale color to his physique, under certain lighting, a paler physique is going to look really crazy under that lighting. Because when you talk about contrast, it's the contrast between black and white, the darkness and the shadows created on your physique. So the lighter your physique is, the whiter your physique is, it's going to look better than other physiques under certain lighting. And I think James is an example of that. He's kind of a paler guy. And under the right lighting, he looks crazy grainy. And you've seen this with guys like Evan Santapani, Dorian Yates, some of his off-season pictures where he looks, or not off-season, but prep pictures where he looks super grainy. And that's part of the mystique of bodybuilding, because a lot of it comes down to lighting and angles and all that good stuff. So the question is going to be if James's conditioning is going to translate as well on stage with a tan under stage lighting. Because again, it's this contrast effect. It's the balance between the lightness and the darkness that makes the physique look so crazy. And you see this a lot with guys with a much more pale physique because of the way the contrast works with their, you know, separation. It makes them look a lot more detailed, and it might not look that way on stage. So in pictures, James looks like he's about to win this show, but it's really going to be a question of whether or not that translates on stage. So in addition to the Spain show, I want to talk about the Chicago Pro, because the lineup for the Chicago show was just released. So I want to talk about that a little bit. So the Chicago Pro is next weekend, and this is the last opportunity to qualify for the 2020 Mr. Olympia. The cutoff date to qualify for the Olympia is October 18th. And the Chicago Pro is the 16th through the 17th next weekend. So that being said, in men's open bodybuilding, you have 22 competitors at the Chicago Pro. Eddie Bracamontes, Camilo Diaz, Chris Dicamenico, Phil Klahar, Muhammad El Imam, Stephen Frazier, Johnny Jackson is in this lineup. That was a name that really surprised me to see that in there. Johnny Jackson is going to be in the Chicago Pro lineup. Noir, Cobby, Kyle, Kervog, On and Nguyen. This is a guy to look out for. On Nguyen is jumping in Chicago in the point standings. I believe he's in a tie with Rami. Yeah, so this could be bad news for Rami. On Nguyen being in this lineup, him and Rami are in third place in the point standings. They're tied for third with 9 points each. And if On places in this Chicago Pro, that will put him above Rami. And again, the top three in the point standings at that cutoff date on October 18th, they all go to the Olympia as well. So On could be a guy that knocks Rami off this list. We talked about this in yesterday's video. But On being in this Chicago lineup, that is bad news for Rami if On Nguyen places. So you've also got Bola, Ojex. I saw him comment this post when I posted it on my community tab on my page, and he said he's doing 212, so he's not going to be in men's open. You got Joshua Plasencia, Eric Ramirez, Justin Rodriguez. That's a lot of people's favorite to win the show because he was runner-up at the New York Pro a few weeks back. Joe Seaman, he was at the Cali Pro a few weeks back. Muhammad Shaban, Sean Smith, there's a lot of people talking about him as well. Derek Upshaw Morgan, Josh Wade, another guy a lot of people are talking about. Nick Walker, who is the talk of this show. Nick Walker just earned his pro card at the North Americans this year. This will be Nick's pro debut, and a lot of people have him as a potential favorite to win based on the size that he's got, the freak factor that he's got, and just the overall, you know, he's a dominant presence. He could win this show. You've also got Akeem Williams, and you've also got Keith Williams. So again, 22, well, if Bola is not in this lineup, 21 guys in men's open bodybuilding at this Chicago Pro. It's going to be a really good show. Now, if you go over to Nick Walker's Instagram page, Nick Walker, again, he's kind of the talk of the show. It's going to be his pro debut. He's a guy that a lot of people feel has a lot of potential. I believe Nick is only 25. Really young guy, ton of potential, ton of size. And the question is really going to be, A, conditioning, and B, controlling his midsection in the transitions primarily are the things that we're looking for from Nick. But he's got the size. He's definitely already got the size to hang with any of these names in this list. He's about 250 pounds at 5'7", I think he is. So he's got a ton of size for his height. He's got a ton of muscle on his frame. He's already got all the size to hang with any of these guys. The question is going to be conditioning in the midsection. That's what you're going to want to be looking for from Nick. But in this recent physique update, his midsection looks tight to me. So as long as he keeps that midsection tight in the transitions, and he comes in a little bit drier, a little bit harder, a little bit more conditioned than he came in at the North Americans, I think Nick is going to be very dangerous here. And honestly, it's hard to predict a winner. Again, these lineups are so deep, and a lot of these guys is kind of unknown how they're going to look next to some of these other guys because they've never been next to him before. But I think he's going to be top three guaranteed. Now, if you go over to the 212 bodybuilding list, obviously another thing a lot of us are looking forward to seeing is Keon Pearson's 212 debut at the Chicago Pro. There might be trouble for Keon here. Noel Adame is the first name in this lineup, and I believe he won the Indy Pro of last year, and he was really impressive. And this guy, I originally predicted I think Keon's going to win. With Noel being in this lineup, Noel, he's very dangerous. He's very complete. He's very big. He's going to be a tough guy for Keon to beat. So Noel is going to be very dangerous in this lineup. You've also got Marco Cardona, Jason Herbert, Kevin Johnson, that's my boy, Austin Carr, Eric Langlois, Jason Lowe, that's my boy as well. I love Jason. You got Keon Pearson, of course, Steve Thayer, Adam Young, and Daryl Young. So not that crazy, not that deep of a lineup, not that many guys. It's like 10 names right there. But the guys you're going to want to be looking out for, again, Noel Adame, he's very dangerous. Kevin Johnson, Jason Lowe, Keon Pearson, those are the big names that stand out to me as some serious factors in this lineup. So you're definitely going to want to be on the lookout for them. Also, next up in the news, Hunter Labrada. Hunter is looking extremely dangerous in his most recent physique update on his Instagram page. And I've said this before, Hunter is one of my favorite stories of the year because Hunter, he did his pro debut at the Tampa Pro. He took about a year, a little over a year off between turning pro and his pro debut. Took that time to really put on some quality gains to his physique. He won his pro debut in Tampa, and now he's going straight to the Olympia. And, of course, he's documenting his preparation for the Olympia. He says in the caption of this post that this is the smallest and fattest I'll be the rest of the year. You only get one rookie season. I'm going to end it with a bang. Absolutely killed my push session today with B Troy Anello, been firing on all cylinders all year, and today was just another chance to get better, and we did that 71 more days to win. So, like I said, Hunter's one of my favorite stories of the year, won his pro debut, going straight to the Olympia, and honestly, I think Hunter is going to be solidly within that top 10 at his first Olympia ever, which is going to be a tremendous accomplishment. And in these pictures, I think it's kind of funny that he says this is the fattest and smallest he will be, because he doesn't look fat and he doesn't look small in any of these pictures. I think he's got great shape. He's got great structure. He's got really kind of that freak factor to his physique that we've talked about with other guys. Look at that vascularity throughout his upper body, his chest and his shoulders. He looks good, man. He's got all the size he needs to compete with men's open guys. He proved that at the Tampa Pro. He came in shape at the Tampa Pro. Great structure, small waist, great posing, of course, with Lee Labrada as your father. You can't have bad posing. I'm telling you guys, I predict it right now in this video, Hunter Labrada will be top 10 at his first Olympia ever. I think it's going to happen. Now, the final story today, another update from Brandon Curry. They're filming a little video there for his Road to the Olympia video series. Yet another post from Brandon with the hashtag beefcake in the description or in the comment section or whatever you would call that of that post. Brandon, of course, looking as full and round as he always looks, looking to be in pretty good shape. And I'm really excited for this year's Mr. Olympia. I kind of thought for a while that it might not happen with everything that's going on. And then I kind of thought it might not be that exciting of a show because people might not be able to get there. Competitors might not be able to compete. It's shaping up to be one of the best Olympia lineups we've ever had in the history of the Olympia. And I could not be more excited to see Brandon versus Phil. Hopefully we'll see Rami get there, to see Bonac and to get to see Hadi and to get to see, all these guys, Dexter. Flex Lewis is making his men's open debut at the Olympia. Rolly Winkler's going to be there. It's going to be a hell of a show, and I can't wait to watch it. Let me know in the comment section below your guys' top six Olympia predictions for 2020. And that's going to wrap it up for the video today, guys. I hope you did, in fact, enjoy it. Please give it a thumbs up, a big old thumbs up if you did enjoy it. Please subscribe to this channel if you have not subscribed already. We're on the road to 1 million subscribers, and right now we are at 965,000, 35,000 away from that million. So make sure you hit that subscribe button. I love you guys. I appreciate you guys. And as always, Nick Strength and Power signing out.